Holistic Parts Works, and we're in Pilot Hill, Texas, ready for our next level one class. This is Rockstar. This is Shalise's owner. She's going to let me do an evaluation for you guys. As you know, I always start with the head. And if you come up and look at two cheekbones, you'll notice that on his right side, this side's lower. When you come down and look at the nostrils, you'll start to see that. And when you look at the eyes up here, you'll start to see that. And you can look at it best when the horse's nose is down, like you're feeding him a treat. What I was noticing on him, on his frontal and nasal bone, these are all jammed down. This is smooth, this one comes over and is bumpy, and this one's actually jammed down onto this one. This is not a Roman nose horse. Okay. So when you come up here, the occiput's going to be totally flat and smushed in his head, but she noticed when she felt up there, there was no bone up there. Right side's lower. So his right side's about a half inch lower. Remember I told you if you bit up a horse and you measure down to each lip line, you'll see one side is lower, so he's heavier on right rein. And I asked her about that. She said, yeah. We did some body evaluating, and he has first rib out under right shoulder. When I say first rib out, it's not like it's poking out. It's just not in perfect alignment, so it doesn't allow the shoulder to come through freely. So it's not causing him pain. It just doesn't allow perfect. So picking up right lead canter is difficult for him. That's going to transfer back to the hind end. When we watched him walk in, the right hind was coming through stiff. That's a compensation of the front end. When I come through here, she said he had done a pullback.
Yes, he flipped over and smacked his head on the way down, all the way back.
And then some Western medicine professionals will say the horse is fine. I don't. So this is already compressed. In my level 3 class, we pull this up, and that's all your head shy horses that don't like to be bridled. It's not a training issue. They actually have a lot of pain up here.
Mm-hmm.
So you can use the dynamite release spray and spray that on every day and start with my level 1 cranial video. He did some misalignment and atlas and axis. When I push here, it's going to be very sore. He's like, oh, yeah, oh, touch, touch. Very defensive. So nicely turning your head down, but he doesn't do it with joy and ease.
No,
he's like, I'm doing it because I'm supposed to, not because I want to.
Absolutely.
When I come down to here, the indicator for first rib is out on this side, so he can't bring right shoulder through freely. It's going to give you the higher heel on your high lows on the front end when you're trimming. The side that compensates is the bigger hoof.
Okay.
With the flatter heel. The side that can't do its job is the more narrow donkey hoof. Makes sense?
40 feet?
No. So when I come back to here, when the first rib is out, it pulls the withers out of alignment. It almost looks like scoliosis. And if you come in closer, you'll see that the wither bone actually comes off center and doesn't stay under the middle of the mane. So just knowing that, I can squeeze in here, and I know he's really not going to like it. He says, ouch. And you can do little things like this. Hello, buddy. Oh, you're going to learn all this in the class. Nice and soft. Yeah. How is that? And then you can squeeze in there, and it doesn't hurt anymore. And that's something that you need to do every day.
Okay.
Because when you have a low heel and a high heel, it's like us standing on shoes like this. It's going to show down. So in the yoga and the body work in 30 days, you're throwing down great feet, and you don't need to do it so much anymore.
Okay. Every day.
When I scratch in here, he's not going to be able to do a belly lift very well. Just lift all the ribs on one side. Issues, you're just trying to put a straight saddle on a crooked horse.
Okay.
And you need to realign your horse before you put him into repetitive work.
Can you
just
show me
holding him up every
again?
Day.
Oh, wow, that's great.
Wow.
Okay. So if they can't expand their ribs, they can't even listen to a leg kick. They can't lift to collect.
Okay.
And they're pulling with the front end when they're cantering instead of launching and pushing with the hind end.
Absolutely.
When I check the hips, this one's going to be back. This one's here and this one's here. So this hip is back and also dropped. Okay, so your horse is not a car. It doesn't come with perfect alignment. They're out of alignment by 7 months of age. That's a horse that's left or right side dominant or stronger on one side, mm-hmm. and they're not training in behavioral issues. You don't do more capillaries. You don't do more hip,
Okay.
You just come in and put your hips in. And in the class, we just show you. If you come up here, you'll see a little shift and change. All I'm going to do is push on the magic spot, and you're going to see this shift and change. This hip is way back here. Ready, buddy? I know. What was that? Sharp fingernails. Look at those eyes. One more time. You ready?
Yeah.
So now when I slide back, both hips are even. So my goal is to teach you to do that, because when the body's out of balance, the hooves are out of balance. We can see this hoof isn't perfect, that hoof isn't perfect. Mm-hmm. And that's because of how the body wants to stand on the hoof.
Okay.
When it's sore up here, it's going to be like this. When it's comfortable, it's going to be like this. When it's like this, you can grow down a balance hoof that's going to hold the chiropractor.
Okay.
Until then, you got to check it every day. He'll be up by 2 inches, then 1 inch, then a half an inch, until he's holding his alignment, and the feet are there to support the alignment. Okay? Right here is going to be really sore. When we were watching him walk in, he was just kind of straight through like this. So I just know without even checking that when I push here, that's going to go into spasm. So this hip was back, but it's also dropped like this.
Okay.
Okay, so stifle and hops can't work correctly. You'll get more arthritis on that side. Okay, it'll be stiffer to use right hind. Can't turn and pivot. No. And all you got to do for this one, hi, buddy. There. See how tight and sore it was and how it just goes to jello now?
Wow.
Yeah, now I'd be able to do my little butt tucks. So the yoga is designed as your check. People say, well, they can't do the butt tucks well, because the hips are out. Your hips are in alignment and the body's in alignment. The yoga is a 4.5 minute routine. So if you do the yoga before you ride it and have a glitch, then you know you need to fix it.
Nobody has ever been able to get him to do any of that.
Wow. We got Layla and everybody and all you guys here now. And you keep doing this, and he'll be able to collect and use his hind end, and he'll be able to lift. And then you start working on getting the withers. So when you see horses that are downhill, your scapula should be here and your wither should be this much higher.
Okay.
You do not want to see scapula or wither.
Okay.
That's going to give you the heavy on the forehand horse. And then we're using the bit in our seat to try and bring it back. And the only thing we have to pick up a heavy front end with is this. So okay. We put this on the spasm. Where the yoga and the body work is about finding the position of the front end. So that the front end can move back. And then your horse gets taller. And then you can go on the front end instead of like a front end. And this is what we do if your horse is colicking, because it moves things around in large and small intestine. You could combine these two. And then they'll usually pass a lot of gas.
Okay.
So it's something to do while you're waiting. So he has a crooked head, he's ever on right rein. First rib isn't where it should be, not allowing this shoulder. We're not doing that in this video, we're doing that in the class. These were just the compensations of this not being able to work right. So they're gonna come back. Most body workers aren't doing first rib, so they're treating the same symptoms all the time.
That is just carrying through his whole body.
Right.
Because we're not working with the actual problem.
Yeah, okay. This is usually up by the time they're 7 months old. This happens running in a pasture, a mud bog,
okay.
Or pulling a front shoe with a hind. So if they ever pull a front shoe with a hind, you know you got to release that for sure.
Good to know.
Well, thank you, buddy, for being in our video. Bye-bye.